Hey everyone, today it's all about VST plugins and my recommendations for maybe the upcoming Black Friday sale. And some of the plugins I want to show you today are just that, recommendations, and some of them I tend to use a lot, maybe even in every project. And the first one is called Dynamic Spectrum Mapper. And it looks like this, and it's a dynamic multiband limiter plugin where you can capture a frequency distribution curve, or the threshold curve here, and apply it to your own tracks. So because everything above this line becomes limited and pushed down, it works like a magic EQ at the same time. So it's a magic EQ and a multiband limiter at the same time. And in this case here, I'm using it on the master bus, and I use it on the drum bass bus, and I use it on the drums bus. And you can see there's not much compression going on. I just use it to notch the whole frequency distribution in the right direction on each step. So it's just a touch to push it in the right direction, so it becomes a nice whole mix down in the end. And as I said, I use it a lot, basically in every project, and it has some neat features, even a brick wall limiter at the end. And yeah, try it out, maybe try the trial version. The price is a bit steep. Normally it's about $324, I think, but I got it for $40 some years back, so maybe you have a chance to get it for much cheaper price at the Black Friday sale. So look out for that one. It's my first recommendation. So this is my second one. It's called Grain Space by Audiority, and it's a grain delay FX plugin, or for me more like a texture generator, because it adds so nice textures to all kinds of sounds. And let's start off by this is the original sound. This is a dry wet signal knob here, where you can mix between the dry and the wet signal. And the init patch or init preset does basically nothing. So let's stretch the feedback buffer. It gives a nice granular delay effect. And if we rise the randomized size knob here, we can change the size of each grain randomly, which results in a nice stereo effect. Then we can apply pitch to the grains and mix in the original signal. There we have it, we have a nice texture created out of the original sound itself, added on top of the sound. And if you need a reverb, there's also one ordinary reverb integrated. Or use the smear knob for blending each grain into each other. So you have a more smoother transition between each grain. And if you randomize the pitch, you get very strange results. There are some more parameters, but one thing I want to show you is this button at the top, which randomizes each parameter inside the plugin. So you have, every time you push the button, you get the interesting starting point. I think every VST plugin should have such a button. It's so nice. Yeah, this plugin costs maybe, I think, $29 or so. But maybe in the Black Friday sale, you get it much, much cheaper. So this is my third recommendation. It's called Wise by Neusonic Arts, and it's a slice sampler. And if you use Bitwig and need a better alternative for slicing samples, then this is the way to go. And there's also a nice feature with the trial version or with the demo version. As you can see, it's fully working for 60 minutes. And there's no drawback, so you can use it on every instance for 60 minutes, chop up your loops and then bounce it out, and then you're good to go. You don't need a full version if you're okay with that workflow. So let's start the demo for 60 minutes, and then we can track our drum loop in, and then it's automatically sliced up. And if you use a keyboard, you can instantly trigger each slice on the keyboard. You have a sensitivity slider here where you can add or remove the slides on the fly. And if you're ready, then you choose your beats or the length of the loop, which is 170 beats per minute. It's okay. And then you can drag out the MIDI clip on here. And then you have your loop, which is very nice, because now you can select all slices and then pitch them. Or you can pitch each slice individually, or of course apply some envelopes to it. And when you're ready, you can just bounce in place, and then you have your loop set up, and then you can remove the VST and you're done. And also by the same company is this plugin, which is also my fourth recommendation. It's called Granite, and it's a regular granular synth, but it has some nice features, and I want to show you. This also has a demo version which works for 60 minutes, so you can use it 60 minutes and bounce your result out and use it. So let's start the demo here and drag in our own sound. Activate the gate so we don't hear a sound constantly. And then I want to reset the plugin to initial state. And okay. So you can use our keyboard to play back the sample. Manipulate this playback speed. Even play it backwards. Add some space between each grain. Add some density. Or even add some FX. And what I really like about this plugin is the automation recording. There you have some circles around the knobs, which you can use to record automation on the fly. So just use the circle here, click and hold the mouse button and record. And if you release it, it instantly plays back the automation. This also works here for the start and end parameters, end points. So let's track it at the top here at this red arrows. Release, and then it plays back your movement. And so you can create nice, interesting living, breathing, moving sounds out of old samples. It's a very interesting plugin, of course, to create some nice pads or drones for your sampler. And you also can use a right click to reset every parameter to its default value. So right click here, right click here. And you can set up a new patch. So very easy to create pads with this thing. So look out for this one. It's called Granite by New Sonic Arts, and I like it very much. So my fifth recommendation and my last recommendation is called Diffuse by Surya Machines, and it's a mixture of a delay and a reverb. So literally you can blend between each mode. So this is the tri-signal here. It's a piano by Sound Iron. So mix in the reverb. So if you have diffuse at 0%, you have basically a delay. Feedback. And then modulate it a bit over time. So it sounds much more interesting. And then you can raise the diffuse button here, and it becomes much more like a reverb. And if you want loud and thick sounds, then you can raise here the pump parameter. I think it's a compressor. Or can spread the stereo signal. I really like this plugin for pet sounds and ambient songs, so try this one out. I think it's not very expensive. And this is my last recommendation for this video, so look out for every plugin on the Black Friday sale. Or maybe you buy it for the full price because you like it so much. Would be an option. So thanks for watching this video. Leave me a like if you liked it. And subscribe to the channel, and thanks to my Patreons for all the donations. Until next time, see you and bye.